Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we are going to learn how to identify weak bases in organic chemistry, of which there are many. So we're going to look at trends. We're not going to look at KB tables. We're going to look at general trends, and then we can apply those trends to any systems that we see. We just have to identify which trend we're looking at. So we'll look at size, the contribution of resonance, and then the combination of electronegativity and charge as it applies to basicity. We will first look at size as a general trend and how it impacts basicity. So as I go down the periodic table, the atoms are going to get larger because they have more and more electrons, so more of those shells are filled and the volume of each atom is larger. So I picked the halogens, but you could apply this to any series of bases if you're going down the periodic table, because size is going to be the biggest factor impacting basicity if your series of bases is within the same column, so going down the periodic table. So this fluoride ion here is going to be small relative to the iodide ion here, which is going to be much larger. The larger the atom is, the more space there is to distribute that charge out over. So the smaller atom in that series is going to be more destabilized by the charge. Because that charge is in a smaller area. And because of that, this is going to be the strongest base. So the smaller an atom is, the more compact that charge is, the more repulsion there's going to be, and so the more reactive it will be in the stronger base. So fluoride is a stronger base than chloride, than bromide, than iodide. Iodide being the largest, and so it would be the weakest base in this series. And you could apply this to any series of bases that are in one column. So the main factor influencing basicity in that case would be the size of the atom. In this example, we'll look at the presence of resonance and its impact on basicity. So I have two series here. I have this oxide here, and then I've got a carboxylate ion over here. And this carboxylate ion is capable of resonance. And so the lone pair of electrons, one of the lone pairs on this oxygen, can come down and fold in and make a double bond there and kick these electrons up. And that would give me this structure here. So I have the negative charge spread out over those two atoms, and really it's kind of like each oxygen atom has a half of a negative charge on it. So I've used those dotted lines there to show partial pi character, partial double bond character. Since these atoms are both oxygens and their electronegativity is the same, their affinity for electrons is equal. And so it's more like there's a half of a negative charge on the top oxygen and a half on the bottom oxygen. And so that resonance is stabilizing that molecule, because the charge is delocalized and spread out over more atoms. And so this is going to be a weaker base because it's stabilized. And if it's stabilized, then it's less reactive. So the oxide with its localized charge is going to be more reactive than any species that has a charge that is delocalized over multiple atoms. So resonance is another trend that you can apply to any analogous system. So the presence of resonance is going to be stabilizing and therefore make that compound a weaker base than an analogous system without it. And in the world of organic chemistry, any resonance-stabilized compound is going to be a weak base. This oxide compound is one of the few strong bases in organic chemistry. And if you want an overview of strong bases, I have a separate video on that. The last group of weak bases that we'll look at is neutral molecules. So neutral molecules are not going to be particularly reactive because they're not charged. Common derivatives of neutral bases are NR3, where R is a C or an H, or OR2. So water we've seen act as a base numerous times, methanol and other derivatives as well. Nitrogen is less electronegative than oxygen, and so I think it can be informative to think about what, in this case, the conjugate acids would look like. So if NR3 acts as a base, it will accept a proton, and it will become HNR3, and that will be positively charged. If oxygen accepts an electron, it'll be HOR2, and it will be positively charged. And nitrogen being less electronegative then oxygen is going to be less destabilized by that positive charge. It has less of an affinity for electrons, and so it's less destabilized by the positive charge. And so those amine derivatives, NR3, are going to be stronger bases than my oxygen derivatives, even though neither of them are particularly strong bases. They would still all be categorized as a weak base. And that is, again, because this is going to be less destabilized by that positive charge. So that is a quick look at what general trends can influence basicity and what trends tend to make for a weak base. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends, and I'll see you next time.